This Sunday morning is the first mass here since this shocking Pennsylvania grand jury report detailing allegations of widespread predatory behavior by more than 300 priests against more than 1,000 children. I'm standing here at St. Matthew's Cathedral because before Donald Wuerl, the powerful cardinal of the Washington diocese, was hosting popes in this town, he was bishop in Pittsburgh for 18 years, and he was named throughout this report as one of the bishops who helped cover up the crimes. The archdiocese declined our invitation to interview Cardinal Wuerl, but this week in his defense, the cardinal said, quote, "The report confirms that I acted with diligence, with concern for the victims, and to prevent future acts of abuse," unquote. The Pennsylvania Attorney General, Josh Shapiro, well, he disagrees, telling me exclusively, quote, "Cardinal Wuerl is not telling the truth. Many of his statements in response to the grand jury report are directly contradicted by the church's own documents and records from their secret archives." Among Wuerl's claims that do not stand up to scrutiny,
"I think I did everything that I possibly could."
Everything? Father Richard Zula and Father George Zerwas of the Pittsburgh Diocese were two from a group of priests who, the grand jury found, quote, "manufactured child pornography," end quote, used whips, violence, and sadism in raping their victims. In 1988, Zula was arrested and charged with more than 130 counts related to child sex abuse. Now, a spokesman for Wuerl notes that Zula had been removed from his ministry before Wuerl came to Pittsburgh in early 1988, and that's true. But in 1989, Cardinal Wuerl authorized a $900,000 confidential settlement between the diocese and two of Zula's victims, and that included a hush agreement. The diocese under Wuerl's leadership also hired a doctor who worked with Father Zula to lessen the sentence with a statement that the grand jury found, quote, "blamed the child victim rather than the adult criminal," and the diocese under Wuerl helped to secure Zula's early release.
Did you ever move priests quietly to another?
That wasn't our process.
Actually, it was the process with Father George Zerwas. The Diocese of Pittsburgh under Wuerl, who started there in 1988, quote, was aware of complaints against Zerwas for sexually abusing children as early as 1987. Additional complaints were received between 1987 and 1995, and that includes in 1988 and 1991 while Wuerl was bishop of the diocese, quote. However, Zerwas continued to function as a priest during this period and was reassigned to several parishes, unquote. Despite all this evidence, a spokesman for Wuerl maintains that he acted promptly in this case and removed Zerwas.
If there were allegations, we dealt with them immediately.
Immediately? Really? The predatory behavior of Father Ernest Paoni dated back to the early 1960s. And Paoni was shuffled from parish to parish all over the country. In 1991, Cardinal Wuerl approved moving Paoni to the Diocese of Reno, Las Vegas, even though the Pittsburgh Diocese knew of Paoni's past. And in 1996, Wuerl refrained from sharing everything the Pittsburgh Church knew about Paoni's past with the Diocese of San Diego. Now, Wuerl's defenders note that as bishop in Pittsburgh, he disciplined some priests and he fought the Vatican against an order to reinstate a predator priest. The report notes that Wuerl had previously written to the Vatican that parishioners had a right to know if their priests were pedophiles. And a spokesman for Wuerl says he acted promptly to notify others about the claims against Paoni when he learned of them. But the grand jury disagreed, writing, quote, "In spite of Wuerl's statements to the Vatican, the clear and present threat that Paoni posed to children was hidden and kept secret from parishioners in three states. Wuerl's statements had been meaningless without any action," unquote. Now, those are just three stories from a report in which Cardinal Wuerl's name appears 170 times. The cardinal claims to answer to a higher authority. When will he answer on this earth for allegedly covering up crimes against children?